Hi everyone, Mr. Morgan Lewis here at the school. In this video, we're going to talk about some hamstring exercises that you will need to use a light weight for. Okay, dumbbell, kettlebell, a 5 liter water bottle will do it. Just something that you can manage. And these exercises are gauged at trying to encourage the hamstrings to stretch a bit more and also make some light strengthening happen for them as well. We don't want to go too heavy because you run the risk of obviously tearing the muscle and really injuring yourself. This is quite good for those that struggle naturally with flexibility or particularly with the hamstrings. So follow these exercises and you'll notice the difference. Make sure you pay attention to form as well, because you should feel it here, not here in the back. So the first one's a single leg deadlift. So what you need to do is hold the weight, same side as the leg you're going to work. Balance is quite tricky on this one, so it's also good, but you've got to counterbalance with your other arm if you need it. As you do this, what you've got to do is hover your leg off the ground, the one that hasn't got the weight on it, or the same side, and then you're going to kick the leg back as you drop forward. But as you do it, you're going to have your arms counterbalance, all right, and you're just going to let the weight pull you down like that, and then you come back up, and you don't let the foot touch the floor. So what you've got to do is you've got to go down, let the weight take you, okay, and then you bring yourself up carefully. As you can see, it's quite a tricky one to balance on, all right, so it's here, and then I'm back in, and down, and then up, and you should really feel it stretching that leg. And when you pull it up, you're not actually pulling it, you're actually using the standing motion to pull it for you. So when you get to here, just stand completely straight up. See, my arm is completely straight, I don't actually bend my elbow, okay? And then of course you do the same other side. So same arm, same leg, all right, go down, counterbalance, up, all right, down, counterbalance, and up. All right, that's the first one. Then the second one is a double side version of that. So for this one, first of all, before I actually do the movement, pay attention to form. Do not do this. You'll feel it in your lower back. And if you're pulling up this kind of, you know, light weights, you can hurt yourself. So from here, you've got to go directly down from the waist. Now let's say you get there before you can't go any further, that is absolutely fine. That is why you've got the weights in your hand. That the weights will pull you down a bit further for you, they'll help you. So you go like this, you want your palms facing your knees, okay, you go down with the straight back, okay, so you can feel it pulling, and then you just stand. You don't move your arms, you just stand, and when you stand you push your hips forward. All right, so watch again, really slow, so it's there. Okay, keep your back straight, your head up, so you notice that my posture is good, and then it's up and there. And it feels like a stretch, and you know, you're working, it feels like a contraction at the same time. So it's quite a good exercise, but you've got to make sure your form is, you know, proper, all right? Otherwise you're gonna run the risk of hurting yourself. So, a couple more times. So leg straight, feet parallel, straight down. Remember your arms are not involved, they're just there to pull the weight down. All right, you go down, and then you pull using your legs, okay? Last one, I recommend you do this with one side just to start with, but you can do it with both sides, with both weights in your hands. From here, okay, a lunge, nice and easy. Lunges are really good for the quads, but they're really good for the hamstrings if you do it right. So the key is the pushback. So I'm gonna hold the weight, the same side as the leg I'm gonna work, just gonna work one leg. Okay, I'm gonna step forward, make my lunge. Okay, but what I'm gonna do, keeping this straight, is I'm gonna really push with my hamstring here to push it back into the position again. All right? When you go, if you go backwards doing it, it still works the hamstring to some extent, but because the heel's already off the floor, there's not a lot of tension there. So you just concentrate on going forward. Because what you want me to, what I want you to see is this. You see my heel is flat. I go down and then I don't stand and then push, I push from here. Yeah, and that really, really gets the hamstring going, okay? You're gonna feel it in the quads as well, but you need to do it a fair few times. So that's gonna be one rep. You do that as many times as you feel able to, and then of course you swap sides, okay? If you wanted to do both, all right, to save yourself a bit of time, then of course you have both of them here, all right? You step forward one, push back, step forward two, push back, and remember the timing, look, here, go down, don't stand, then push. Push from here, there, like that, to really engage those hamstrings, okay? So you've got single leg deadlifts with counterbalance, okay? You have dual stiff leg deadlift here, and then of course you have your lunges as well. So it's here and back. Okay, it's a few exercises for you to try. I'll give you one more while I'm here. For this one, you can just use the space provided. A lot of you have done this in lessons before, but it's simply to go into this position here. All right, legs nice and straight, and you want to try and bring your feet closer to your hands without coming off the ground, like this. And then you move your legs back, and then you can do it with your hands moving closer to your legs. So that really, really encourages the stretch, okay? So there's a few options there for you to try and add to your routines, or, you know, try them by themselves. How many to do? Because you've got lightweight, really 20 reps, if you can do it, of each exercise. Then after that, see how you feel, maybe you can do another round, all right? Generally with lighter weight and high reps, 15 plus is really what you want to aim for. So you can feel the equivalent that it of fatigue that will be the same as lifting heavier. It just means it takes a little bit longer. All right, enjoy, have a go at those. Let us know how you get on. Like and share the video, and stay tuned for more fitness advice and training exercises, okay? Take care of yourselves.